Guys, believe it or not, the Apple credit card finally came out today. Now, both these things are not the Apple credit card. I just need a placeholder, something to hold in my hand so I can talk about it. Now, we saw this first time at WWDC, and Apple, you know, pretty much found a really smart way of making a ton of money for literally no reason if you think about it, because this Apple credit card is actually pretty much sponsored through Goldman Sachs. So it's not like Apple's doing all this stuff. They're pretty much just putting their branding on it. But Goldman Sachs is taking care of the rest. Now, for some reason, the iPhone 5S is not supported with the Apple credit card. I'm not too sure why that's the case. It supports almost everything. I'm pretty sure it still supports Apple Pay as well, so don't really understand that too much. But the question is, should you go and apply and get the Apple credit card? Now, me being the financial literate person I am, you know, I run a multi-dollar company, you know, that's a pretty decent thing, trait that I have. So with all my experience, should you actually go and apply and get the Apple credit card? Now, I'll tell you this, there's really nothing bad about this specific card. There's really nothing. I mean, it's like a standard credit card almost. But the cool thing is that it is pretty much applied and sponsored through Apple. So if you have an iPhone, apparently the process to go and apply for and all that stuff is super easy from what I'm reading. As far as I know, I don't know anybody who's gotten declined or disabled or declined from actually getting that credit card. So that's pretty good. Maybe they're trying to accept as many people as possible. But I'm pretty sure they do a background check and all of that. The cool thing is though is that for a beginner credit card, it's not even a beginner. I mean, it's a pretty decent thing. There's no late fees, there's no fees like that, but I think it is a little weird because there is interest on the payment that you don't pay every month. For example, if you owe like $1,000 and I don't even know how much the percentage is, let's say it's like 3% or whatever, you'll still end up paying like $30 extra if you have a late fee or something like that, if you don't pay on time, if you don't pay the full amount. But there isn't a late fee as long as you pay the minimum amount, which is, I guess, a cool thing. So it's not like you just never pay interest on it ever. I mean, I think that's one thing that I noticed at WWDC. It seems like they were kind of alluding to that, but that wasn't really the case. And I kind of thought that for a second too, but I was like, then how would they make any money? They would have to make money somehow. And if you don't pay those payments on time and all that stuff, it'll still severely impact your credit score. But as far as I know, there's no late fees, so that's cool. Now, they actually do have some cool things with the wallet app. Now, I wish I could show you, but I'm not because it has my personal info in it. But if you actually go and use your Apple Pay and things like that, you get a decent amount of cash back, which is really, really cool. But you also get sent a metal credit card, so you can still use that. The points and cash back you get back on those specific points when you use a metal credit card, the actual one that they give you, is a little bit less than the one than if you're actually going to use Apple Pay, which I honestly don't know why. Like, I feel like you should be getting paid more for using the credit card. I don't know, but by using Apple Pay, you can actually just go and utilize it how you usually do and still be able to gain so much more cash back and things. If you're using a debit card, for example, you're not getting any cash back most likely. If you're using a credit card though and you pay it off every month, then you'll be set in that sense. So what I'll tell you is, without rambling, I think it's a decent credit card if it's your first time. You know, there's no annual fee or anything like that. It's built in straight into the wallet app. It's already, you know, it's easy to sign up if you get an invite. And if you're watching this like 3 months down the line, then it's still going to be applicable. However, it's not the best credit card ever. I mean, there's definitely credit cards that can give you way more cash back, even like free sign-up bonuses and all that stuff. But for a beginner credit card, like if you're someone who only uses a debit card, then I would really, or even uses only cash, I would recommend you guys to sign up. But as long as you pay the monthly payment every time in full, just don't pay the minimum amount, pay the full amount every single time. And it's only going to be a win-win. You can actually technically make some money by signing up for this credit card as long as you pay it out in full every single month. So that's a little quick one. I hope you guys understand what I'm trying to say. I think it's a good one for a beginner, but if you're trying to get like the most amount of points or most amount of whatever, you might be better off switching to maybe like a Chase card or American Express or something like that. So that's pretty much all I got to say. If you have any questions or anything, leave it down in the comment section below. Hit that like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count, so it means so much if you guys could hit that. Also, check out the other links down in the description as well. My Twitter, my Instagram, my second channel. All those links are linked down below. I'd really appreciate it if you guys could check it out. But more importantly, than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out, everyone.